everybody. Just thought I'd do a quick video with some stretches in case you're a bit bored and you wanted to improve on your flexibility whilst you're isolating. So make sure you're nice and warm before you start. Just put any song on for 2 minutes, 3 minutes. Run on the spot, do some star jumps, anything that will get your body moving and the blood pumping. And then I'm going to start by warming up the other areas of your body that we might be using today. So we're going to start with your head. We're going to look side to side. Four of those, and then we're going to tilt. And then we're going to go down and up. And then this time, we're going to tilt our head to the side and roll around. We're going to roll to the front. Ready? And then round to the back. Over to the side, round to the front. And then round to the back. Make sure you go in nice and slowly. You don't want to be damaging any of the muscles or the bones or the tendons in your neck. We're going to move on to our shoulders now. So we're going to start with little circles going backwards. Just four of those. Three, four. Then bring your elbows in. Then your arms. Make sure you've got enough space. And then shoulders forwards. And with your elbows. And then your arms. Going to do your ribs now. So if you put your hands on your hips, it'll help to keep your hips and the lower body nice and still. We're going to try and just move our ribs. We're going to go side to side if we can. Other side. Let's come back to the middle in between. I know it's quite tricky. And then to the front. And back. Bit like a contraction. Then we're going to go round. Side, front, side, back. And then the other way. Try and do a big circle with your ribs. And back the other way. And we're going to use our hips. We're just going to go side to side. And then round a few times. And the other way. Okay. Now make sure you've got a good solid stance, maybe a little bit wider than your shoulders. We're going to do a nice stretch with both our arms and our legs, and we're going to start counting in eights. Ready? Five, six, seven, eight. So over. And hold it for eight. And then flat back. You're going to come down to your knee. Try and get your head on your knee. And then over to the other leg. Over to the side, and then come up again. Wait for the new music to kick in. You can go with any pace of music that works for you, anything a little bit faster, a bit slower. I just picked stuff that was nice and steady. Ready? We're going to go back over this side now. Five, six, seven, then flat back. Down. And then your other leg. So flat back again. And then over to the side. We're going to go fours now. And side. The front. And down. Other side. Flat back. Side. And up. Over again. And forward. Down. Other leg. Flat back. Up. And straight. Gonna go again. You're staying in fours. And. Flat. Down. Other leg. Side. Over. Out. And back. Then flat back. Down. This time we're going to stay in the middle. You're going to hold your arms together. Make sure you drop your head down and just swing a little bit from side to side. You're using the weight of your head to try and pull and get yourself a good stretch. You should feel it on the backs of your knees. Just keep going a couple more side to side. Now we're going to reach forwards and through. You're going half time at the minute. You can go full time if you want. Three. Three. And then this time you're going to hold the backs of your legs. Try and pull your head through your legs. Okay. Now we're going to move on and we're going to try and stretch out our hip flexors, which are the muscles that go across the front of our hips here. They'll really help if you're trying to learn how to do the splits. So we're going to start when you come down to the side. It's like a very low lunge. Try and keep your heel down here at the front and use your hands either side of your leg or on one side of your leg just to support your body. I'm going to hold this for 8. Sorry, 16. Then you're going to turn round to the front. If you can, again, get this heel down. I can't. And then we're going to move over. Try and keep your bum nice and low. And again, try and keep that heel down if you can. And we're going to turn to face this side. Try and keep them parallel so then you can really feel it across the front of your hip here. We're going to go back the other way. Face the front. Well, there we go. Got my heel down. And then over. Then come over to this side. We're going to hold for 16 again. Two. This time we're going to come down to our elbows. So you get a stronger stretch here. So I'm going to put our knee down and try and push down even further. Try and get your ribs lower to the floor. You're going to come up. Bend your foot up and you take hold of it with the opposite arm. And then this is going to stretch out your hamstrings, so stretch out this here. Put it down, we're going to sit back and pull our toes towards us and this will stretch out the back of our calves here. Okay, and we come over to the other side and do the same thing. So 16 counts. And onto our elbows. Again for 16. Put your knee down and push yourself lower into the floor. Make sure you're still feeling it on your hip here as well. Reach around. Try and lean forward if you can because then you get the stretch through your hip as well. We're going to come back and pull our toes in. We're going to come onto the side. We're going to be kneeling down, so not like we were when we were moving. You can start with your foot facing up. I'm going to point it down. I'm going to do an 8 for these. And then rotate your legs so your knees facing forward. You'll feel it across here then. And then flex it. And then we're going to do the other leg. So start up with your knee up as well. And then we're going to point down. Make sure you're engaging your knee. Because otherwise you won't feel the benefit on these muscles at the top of your leg. And flex. Okay. From there, we're just going to push our leg back as though you're doing the splits with one leg. And you need to try and push your body to be nice and straight, so again you can feel it across your hip flexor here. Try and keep your legs in parallel. There's no point in turning your leg out because that's going to give you improper technique when you're doing the splits. Just hold that for a little while and then swap your leg. You can lift your arms up, makes it a lot harder. It's really hard to balance. Make sure you're keeping your back knee up though, and you can put your hands down to balance. And then we're going to do the splits like we do when we do it in class. You're going to put your right leg up, put your hands down. Really important to do it this way so you're not damaging any other muscles. You're stretching them evenly by sliding forwards and backwards. Point your toes, flex your feet, it's a different stretch. But make sure you're holding it. If you can go all the way down, try and get your head onto your knee. Sit. Come up. And we're going to try the other leg. Again, make sure you're sliding forwards or backwards because it will stop you from opening up the hips and turning out. Try and straighten at least one leg if you can. As you can see, I can't do the splits. But by the end of this isolation, if I do these stretches every other day, maybe I will. Okay. We're not going to do the box splits because if there's no one there who knows what they're doing to observe you, it could be quite dangerous. So try and stay away from that for now. Now it's time. We're going to sit, make ourselves nice and long. I'm going to sit sideways so you can try and see where I'm using my back. Okay, so we're going to point our toes for the time being, and we're going to brush with our arms. We're going to go along the floor and then come up. Ready? And up. Along and up. Along, up. And then we're going to do the other way. So go forwards and then in. In, forwards, in. And back the other way. So up, up, along, up. And then the other way back. Now we're going to do the one that we know. So point your toes up to the sky. Make sure you've got your magic glue on your legs. Sticking the backs of your knees down to the floor. If you can lift your feet up, great. If not, doesn't matter. You're going to stretch up nice and tall and breathe in. Try and make yourself grow a bit more. And then as you breathe out, you're going to stretch forwards. Try and get your hands over your toes onto the floor. Let your head drop because the gravity again will help pull you further. And come up. Relax down. And breathe in and stretch up again. And go forwards and breathe out. But keep breathing when you're in the stretch, because the oxygen will be taking all the energy to your muscles to try and help them. Okay, we're going to come into frog's legs again. And again, we're going to try and brush in this position. It's a bit difficult because you can't slide along the floor, but you get the idea of the motion. Ready? So we're going to go forwards. And then down. Try not to let your legs bounce up. I know mine are. But try and keep your knees in the same position. Use these muscles here. And then line up this bottom part of your arm with your hand on your ankle and your elbow on your knee. So then you're using your whole arm to help push your knees down. If you can already get your knees nice and flat on the floor, try and bring your legs even closer to your body. And then try and get them down. And now we're going to try and stretch forward with a nice straight back. So we're bending from here at our hips rather than from our waist. So try and lean forwards. If you need to, put your arms up. It really helps with keeping your body kind of straight. Try and hold it for as long as you can and then relax over. If you can get your nose on your toes, excellent. Okay. Now we're going to come into second. Sit in second. Go as narrow, as wide as you can. The more you do the stretches, the wider it'll get. It doesn't matter if yours is only here at the minute, as long as it's a stretch for you. Now this hand, we're going to put our thumb underneath our knee so it's locked in. I'm going to lean over this way and hold it. And you're going to twist your body so you're looking at your leg and you're going to try and get your nose on your knee. It's really important when you're leaning over that you're keeping the other leg nice and stuck to the floor. No point in coming over if this is bent and you've got a big gap under here. So we're going to go the other way. Point your toes if you can. And face your knee. Okay, again we're going to try and lean forwards with a nice flat back. I'll turn to the side in a minute to show you. I prefer this stretch, it helps me get lower. Go to the side. Try and keep your back straight as you can. And then reach down, let your head drop, use the weight of your head to pull you down, try and get your elbows down. If you can get your elbows down, try and get your nose down. If you can get your nose down, try and get your whole front down. If you can do that, try and push your legs out, but make sure that you're not rolling in. Yeah? Try and make sure the tops of your feet are facing up or back. If you want to, you can do the brushes in this position. Or backwards. But the one I prefer to do in second position is reaching from side to side. Again, really important that you stick your bum to the floor. Okay. Put those together, give them a nice wobble. Try and loosen up all those muscles. Now, cross one leg underneath and cross the other leg over the top. If you push away, that'll loosen up all your back. It'll stretch out this muscle a bit. Then you can also turn without moving your legs, and that'll give a stronger stretch to this muscle on the side. Then you swap legs, so that one goes flat. This one hooks over. We'll go up towards to start with. I like to put my arm along the leg to give it more support. And then the other way. Should feel it again down the side here. And one last one, it's really good just to loosen up. If you put one leg out in front like this, so you're a bit of a 90 degree angle and the other one is tucked in a bit at the back, you lean forwards, you should be able to feel it along this side and in your bum. Just let your body rest. And then come the other way. So again, you've got one at a 90 degree angle and the other one, that can be tucked in or it can be out, wherever you feel comfortable. And come forwards again. Okay? And just to make sure you're nice and loose and ready to cool down and go back to your daily activities, just do a couple big breaths in. Let your body drop, bend your knees. And come up, keep it nice and fluid. This part isn't a stretch, this is just a nice little way to get the body pumping the blood around again so it's not stuck in one area of your body. So just a few things to have a go at. Don't have to do them every day, don't have to do them at all. You could do some one day, some another day. Go at your pace, at your level, and hopefully you'll be able to show me some improvements when we get back.